सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनो भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण्युदातिपुरो वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धि प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। अहं नयन्त्यसंसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तवर्जितमानन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। Just a comment on this Gami that I mentioned the last part of this morning. So Yajamana Gami, so it's a Nijanta, so the Akara can be due to the Pratyaya being Nit. So both places interpretation here, Yajamanam Gachati Phalam, that is possible here, but it's a Tachilya Pratyaya. So Tachilam or Tachilyana Gachati can be possible here. Here it seems to be Nijanta only, because Nijanta will also give you the same Rupa, because Nitcha and Nini Pratyaya, Tachil and Nini, both are Nit Pratyas. So the form may be similar with a various difference in Vitpati. That's all. So I just wanted to make a correction there as to the confusion being resolved now. So Purvam यथा यां कांचन यज्ञे इत्यादि वाक्यशेषाद् उद्गीताद्युपासना उपासनासु इत्यादि वाक्यशेषाद् उद्गीताद्युपासनासु इन दि उपासनास ड्यू टू देयर बीइंग अ वाक्यशेषा सो पूर्व यथे यां कांचन यज्ञे सो ऑल दैट दि यजमान डिजायर्स इज अटेन्ड बाय दि ऋत्विक ओनली फॉर द यजमाना यजमाना एव द आशीषास्ते ऑल द आशीष ऑल द डिजायर इज ऑन द पार्ट ऑफ द यजमाना एग्जीक्यूटेड बाय द एग्जीक्यूटेड एंड परफॉर्म्ड बाय द ऋत्विक बट द फला वुड एक्रू टू द यजमाना बिकॉज इट इज फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ द यजमाना अलोन दैट श्रुति हैड been a clincher in the support of Siddhanti's conclusion. So Purva Pakshi brings a drishtanta now, takes this as a drishtanta and brings a darshtantika. He says similar is the case elsewhere. What is the similarity? So udgitadi upasanasu, in the udgita upasana, artvijya nirnaya meaning ritvik karma is the upasana. This is a nirnaya taken with respect to the udgita adi upasana, the pancha bhakti ka samni ityadi was quoted. Tadvat similarly atha munihi atha brahmana iti vidhi vidura vakyasheshat maunasya avidhiyetva nischaya iti drishtanta sangatya idamah. How there was a nirnaya earlier based on shruti, similarly the purvapakshi says in the Jnanakanda also there is similarity as to vidhi vidura vakya sheshat, because vidura here is rahityam, so vidhi rahita vakya sheshat. The vakya shesha is what atha munihi atha brahmanaha in Brihadaranyaka there is a shruti atha muni, thereafter muni, atha brahmana, thereafter brahmana. There is no vidhi there at all. There is no tinganta itself. There is no vidhilinga at all. There is no tinganta itself, let alone vidhilinga. So vidhiling, there is no vidhi at all. Tavya pratyaya ityadi also are not there. There is just a statement, atha munihi, atha brahmana, in the vakyashesha, where you see shravanamana nidhyasana yudhi siddhanti as vidhi, Nididhyasana vidhi also, there is no such vidhi at all, and thereby Vakyashesha. So Vakyashesha is the example. वाक्य शेषा वॉज द क्लिंचर इन दी अर्लियर अधिकरण. सिमिलरली हियर वाक्य शेषा शुड बी द क्लिंचर एज टू देयर बीइंग नो विधि इन निधिध्यासन. इति वाक्यशेषात विधि विदुर वाक्यशेषात मीनिंग विधि रहित वाक्यशेषात दी कंक्लूजन इन दी सेक्शन दैट उपनिषद हैज नो विधि एट ऑल देयर बाय मौनस्य अविधेयत्व निश्चयः. मौन हियर इज निधिध्यासन और यू कैन टेक मौन फॉर नाउ इट विल बी एक्सप्लेन्ड एज निधिध्यासन इन दी सूत्र इन दी सिद्धांत. अविधेयत्व निश्चयः देयरफॉर देयर इज नो विधि रिगार्डिंग मौन और रिगार्डिंग निधिध्यासन इति दृष्टांत संगत्य इदमाह. देयर बाय पूर्वपक्षी हैज प्रोडेड दी सिद्धांति टू ब्रिंग अप सहकारी अंतर विध्यधिकरण. सहकारी अंतर देयर इज अ सहकारी अंग टू दी अंगी विच इज श्रवण. सो मनन एंड निधिध्यासन आर अंगास टू दी श्रवण विच इज द अंगी विच इज द प्रधान. श्रवण इज प्रधान फॉर साक्षात्कार ऑफ मोक्ष. मोक्ष साक्षात्कार इज श्रवण विच इज अंगी एंड इट हैज अदर लिम्स अंगास इन द फॉर्म मनन एंड निधिध्यासन. वेन मनन एंड निधिध्यासन आर डन दे टेक अवे ऑब्स्टैकल्स टू श्रवण फ्रक्टिफाइंग इन टू मोक्ष ज्ञान फल ज्ञानोत्पत्ति एंड देयर बाय मोक्ष. सो द सूत्रकार से सहकार्यंतर विधि पक्षेण तृतीय तद्वतो विद्यादिवत. सहकार्यंतर विधि पक्षेण तृतीय तद्वतो विद्यादिवत. सो सहकार्यंतर विधि सहकारी अंतर अनदर सहकारी देयर आर अदर्स आर सहकारी टू श्रवण एंड सहकार्यंतर विधि इट्स अ विधि. दी सहकारी कारण फॉर ज्ञानोत्पत्ति इज ऑल्सो अ विधि. दैट सहकारी कारण शुड बी फॉलोड. निधिध्यासन शुड बी डन. इट्स अ विधि. पक्षेण तृतीय. सो दिस तृतीय निधिध्यासन इज नॉट ऑर्डेन्ड सेज द पूर्व पक्षी बिकॉज देर इज नो विधि. विधि विदुर वाक्य इज देर एंड इट इज शेष टू एवरीथिंग that you are claiming as the in the jnana kanda. So the pradhana vakyas that you claim which lead to mukti. So sadhana is what? There is no vidhi. Sadhana there is a mention of someone becoming a muni, someone becoming a brahmana, brahmajnani. Sorry. So that kind of phala is heard. There is no vidhi there. This is the Purva Paksha. To which Siddhanti says, no, they are vidhi. They are sahakari karana for jnanotpatti. Therefore, nididhyasana is a vidhi. Nididhyasana and manana also by extension. So, pakshena. This pakshena we will see in the vritti proper. There is a paksha. Paksha means that there are at least two perspectives. So, in one paksha, tritiyam. So in one paksha this nididhyasana is prapta as a vidhi and in another paksha it is prapta without the vidhi. So therefore pakshena. We'll see pakshena proper in the vritti because where there is dvaita bhava in that paksha vidhi is prapta. Or let me just mention it so that we can see it again and speed through. The Purvapakshi says that this Nididhyasana is Chintana Rupa and Brahma Tattva is Sukshma. Mahavakya gives you a Sukshma Vishaya. Very Sukshma. The subtlest of everything, subtler than even Akasha, subtler than Manaha, whatever you know as subtlest in the Prapancha, this is subtler than that subtlest. The Brahma Tattva. Therefore, in the subtle matter, it is well known that vichara, chintana is needed, dhyai chintane. So, nididhyasana is chintana rupa, dhyana rupa. There, in sukshma subject matter, if somebody is narrating some sukshma vishaya, then in such matter, what does the acharya say to the student, the teacher tells the student, or even a friend, something, you know, pay attention. Dhyanena shrunu. So please listen with focus. That is the idea there, dhyanena. So here this dhyana, nididhyasana rupa dhyana, chintana is prapta anyway, is very well known, prasiddha. Why would there be a vidhi? This is the Purvapaksha. So nididhyasana, even if you see as a vidhi, it is an anuvada, because it is already known in the prapancha that sukshma vishaya needs chintana, which is nididhyasana. Shruti need not tell us. This is what the Purvapakshi says. That is one paksha. But Siddhanti says that for the sannyasi who has paroksha jnana, for him it is not prapta really. He does not know that nididhyasana has to be done. One who has no jnana, he thinks that I have to do something for jnana. And one who has jnana, which is aparoksha, there for him, he knows that to stay in this sukshma vishaya, I have to do nididhyasana. I just need to stay here. So therefore, the matter being subtle, how subtle it is, he already knows. It is with the brahmakara vritti, it is siddha to him. So there, advaita understanding is there at aparoksha level. There is no confusion there. And thereby, vidhi may not be needed. But pakshena, in the other paksha where dvaita bhava is prapta even after upadesha, mahavakya upadesha, even after that vastu, although aparoksha, brahma vastu, brahmatma vastu, swarupa, although always aparoksha, even before jnanotpatti, after jnanotpatti also, in baddhavastha as well as mokshavastha, muktavastha, swarupa is always aparoksha. It cannot become paroksha at all. But paroksha vad bhati, therefore the jnana related to this aparoksha tattva also can be paroksha, in which case vidhi is that no, you have a lot to do now to really understand it. Therefore nididhyasana is prapta there. To convert the paroksha into aparoksha, as Ekadeshi would say, but Siddhanti would say, for that the Shravana itself to fructify properly, punaf punaf Shravanam kuryat. But along with that, to take away the obstacles, do Manana and Nididhyasana also. Therefore, Pakshana Tritiyam, this Nididhyasana Tritiya is Tritiya to Shravana Manana also, or to Atha Muni Atha Brahmana. So Munihi and Brahmana are mentioned, but Nididhyasana is the Tritiya. So that is how this Tritiyatvam can be understood. Tadvata means Jnanavataha. Jnanavataha, tadvata is a samasa, tadvataha, not a samasa, sorry, tadvan, it's matupanta taddita, tadvataha, shashti, ekvachana, for the person who is jnanavan, paroksha jnanavan, ityartha, vidyadivata, like vidhi ityadi, what vidhi, karma kanda example will be given, which we'll see in the vritti. Atra purvapakshe maunasya anushtheyatto asiddhi, mauna, maunatvam is not to be seen as a vidhi. So what is this maunatvam will be explained. Siddhante jnanam prati antarangasya tatsiddhiriti phalabheda. In Siddhanta, however, jnanam prati, towards jnana, which is due to shravana. So shravana krita jnanam prati antarangasya sadhanasya siddhi. So tatsiddhi is antarangasya, this is antaranga, it being antaranga. Shravana mana nidhyasana are sakshat, in which Shravana is actually Sakshat by being Angi, and Anga being Manana and Nididhyasana. So they are Antaranga Sadhana. So therefore Tatsiddhi meaning Maunatva Siddhi. Maunasya Anushtheyatva Siddhi. Maunasya Anushtheyatva is Maunatva. Or Maunasya Anushtheyatva can be seen separately also as a practice of Mauna. Is ordained meaning Nididhyasana, since one has to meditate or do Chintana, therefore it is Kriya. So anushteyatva, kriya in the sense vyakrana rupa kriya, anushteyatva. Anushteyatva siddhi iti phala bheda, this is the difference between purva and uttara paksha. Brihadaranyake shruyate, in Brihad Upanishad what is seen, balyam cha panditiyam cha nirvidya atha munihi, so nirvidya atha munihi iti. So atha muni, which was quoted in the sangati here, atha muni, thereafter muni. So lyabanta is nirvidya, having done what? Nirvidya. Balyam cha panditya cha nirvidya. Having attained balya and panditya, So Panditya is with Shravana and Balyam is with the strength of the Jnana. So Balyam is explained in that manner. But Balyam can be Balasya Bhava also, Balyam Shenj Pratya. Tasya Bhava Karmava. So Tasya Bhava also in that sense you get Tadhita Shenj Pratya, or you get it in the sense of Karma also, Tasya Karma. So however the Bala Karma is, Balaka, Balakasya Karma. So that is another meaning also, as per the Purva Pakshi it is Balyam. Meaning childlike, like a child. So having attained that Munihi, one becomes a Muni. So Munihi, this Muni is the Tritiya, which is Atha Muni, this is ordained, says the Siddhanti iti. Tatra kim maunam vidhiyate na vaiti sande na iti Purva Paksha. Mauna is not a vidhi, there is no vidhiling there at all, there is no tinganta itself, says the Purva Pakshi. Siddhantastu phalabhuta sakshatkare shravanadhyapekshaya sahakaryantarasya maunasya niridhyasanakhyasya vidhihi ashritavyaha apurvatvat. Siddhanti says this is apurva, mauna is not prapta. Panditya'm by Shravana we know Panditya can be attained. Balyam, there will be strength of Jnana. As per the Siddhanti, Balyam is the strength of Jnana. This is also with the Jnana you get strength. You get Mithyatva Nishchaya regarding Prapancha. You get that all of that is happening to the Sharira is not happening to you, because your Swarupa is Brahma. Therefore, Mithyatva Nishchaya is Dridha. And one becomes clear that I have no karma, I didn't have any karma, I don't have any karma, but prarabdha sheshat, the sharira is going to continue as long as prarabdha is there. Thereby, one gives into prarabdha, does not fight it, one is comfortable with the prarabdha, how it unfolds, however it unfolds. So this is that balyam, this can be understood there with balyam, the strength of jnana. Tatra kim maunam vidyate no, said the Purva Pakshi. Siddhanti says that phalabhuta sakshatkare, the sakshatkara is in the form of phala of the jnana, Brahma Vidya. So shravanadhya pekshaya, shravana is ordained earlier, shrotavya we have seen elsewhere also. So this shravanadhya pekshaya, in this Upanishad also this shravanadhi apeksha, other than shravana what is needed? Nothing is really needed, because Shravana itself will fructify into Phalabhuta Sakshatkara. However, Sahakaryantarasya Maunasya. Okay, there's some noise. I'll close the window and plug in my earphones. Give me a moment. This is another reason that I have a early morning patha, although there are very few who can attain, because Mumbai gets noisy after on any day, usually it is noisy. Am I audible? Yeah, I hope I am audible. So, Siddhantastu Phalabhuta Sakshatkare Shravanadhyya Pekshaya Sahakari Antarasya Sadhanasya. The another sahakari sadhana is needed for shravanadi to fructify, shravana and manana to fructify. The nididhyasana is ordained for that. This is maunasya, meaning mauna meaning nididhyana, nididhyasana akhyasya, nididhyasanam iti akhya yasya maunasya tad maunam nididhyasa nididhyasanakhyam. And then tasya nididhyasanakhyasya maunasya. So it's a bhauri. Nididhyasanakhya is a bhauri. Nididhyasanakhya. And thereby it's a vidhi. Vidhi called as nididhyasana. That's what is the meaning for mauna. And vidhihi ashritavya. One should take resort to this vidhi and follow the vidhi. One should do nididhyasana so that obstacles to jnana go away. Why so apurvatvat? Why so meaning? Why is it a vidhi? Because it is apurva, it is aprapta. So far, one does not know that nididhyasana has to be done in that section there in Brihat Upanishad. पूर्वपक्षी ननु गार्हस्थ्यम आचार्यकुलं मौनं वानप्रस्थम इत्यत्र मौनशब्दस्य पारिव्राज्ये प्रयोगदर्शनात् कथमत्र मौनं निध्यासनं स्याद् अतः तृतीयम्। पूर्वपक्षी आस्क्स दैट दिस मौन शब्द हैज एब्सोल्युटली नो मीनिंग ऑफ निधिध्यासन एट ऑल बिकॉज वी हैव सीन मौन इन द मीनिंग ऑफ संन्यास एल्सवेयर संन्यास आश्रम। सो ही सेज गार्हस्थ्यम आचार्यकुलम मौनम एंड वानप्रस्थम आर फोर आश्रमस इन अनदर श्रुति। गार्हस्थ्य एंड वानप्रस्थ आर मेंशनड बाय द आश्रम नेम्स सो टू आश्रमस आर कवर्ड गृहस्थ आश्रम एंड वानप्रस्थ आश्रम। आचार्यकुलम हु हैज द राइट टू स्टे इन आचार्यकुल अंतेवासी ओनली ब्रह्मचारी देयरफॉर आचार्यकुल इज लिंग फॉर ब्रह्मचर्य आश्रम। सो थ्री आर कवर्ड फोर्थ रिमेनिंग मौनम पारिशेषद मौनम एंड मौन इज और मुनेर भाव ऑल्सो कैन बी सीन देयर फॉर संन्यास आश्रम यत्याश्रम इट इज इंडिकेटिव ऑफ द फोर्थ आश्रम संन्यास आश्रम पारिव्राज्य। सो इत्यत्र मौन शब्द से पारिव्राज्ये प्रयोग दर्शनात् मौन शब्द हैज बीन यूज इन द श्रुति इन द सेंस ऑफ पारिव्राज्य आश्रम संन्यास आश्रम therefore katham atra maunam nididhyasanam syad how can this word mauna get the meaning of nididhyasana in your case how do you interpret it as nididhyasana atah tritiyam because there is an expectancy of the third says the siddhanti so shravanadya pekshaya nididhyasanam eva atra maunam vidheyam so if you look at shravana and manana nididhyasana is expected there पांडित्यम एंड बाल्यम हैज बीन मेंशन्ड सो बाल्यम कैन बी सीन एज मनना द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ श्रवण कृतज्ञान विच इज मेंशन्ड बाय पांडित्य श्रवण इज पांडित्य एंड बाल्यम कैन बी सीन एज मनना और बाल्यम च पांडित्यम इन विच एवर मीनिंग यू सी थर्ड इज एक्सपेक्टेड देर देर फोर श्रुति से निर्विद्य अथ मुनि ही देर आफ्टर मुनि सो थर्ड इज एक्सपेक्टेड देर because there is a lyabanta there is an expectation of the third what is following and two have been stated therefore the expectancy of the other is the expectancy of the third so shravanadyapeksha nididhyasanam eva atra maunam vidheyam and third has to be nididhyasana itself because shrotavyo mantavyo nididhyasitavya that is the shruti elsewhere so shrotavya mantavya cover shravan and manana third is nididhyasana similarly by extension here mauna should mean nididhyasana स्मृतौ इतराश्रम समभिव्याहारात् निदिध्यासन प्रदानं पारिव्राज्य मौन शब्देन लक्ष्यते इति अविरोधः। देन द पूर्वपक्षी आस सी निदिध्यासन इज द मीनिंग यू आर टेकिंग फॉर मौन शब्द व्हाई वुड यू डू दैट बिकॉज इन स्मृति ऑल आश्रमास आर मेंशन्ड देयर गार्हस्थ्यम आचार्यकुलं मौनं वानप्रस्थम। So Siddhanti says there is no virodha with that shruti also if I take mauna as nididhyasana. Why? Because in the other ashramas, grihastha ashrama, there is a lot of karma. Acharya kula meaning the brahmacharya ashrama also there is some karma. In vanaprastha also upasana pradana, therefore there is karma. Mauna, the sannyasa ashrama there, the meaning of the mauna is sannyasa ashrama in the shruti quoted by the Purvapakshi, there also mauna if it means sannyasa ashrama what is meant there is that sannyasi does not have any other karma than shravana manana nididhyasana whereby nididhyasana is prapta only for sannyasa ashrama in the true sense in the primary sense therefore also if I say mauna shabda means nididhyasana there is no dosha there naisha dosha so he says smrutau itara ashrama समभिव्याहारात् इन स्मृति देर दिस इज अ स्मृति गारस्थ्यम आचार्यकुलम मौनम वानप्रस्थम इज अ श्रुति स्मृति सो इन दैट स्मृति वाक्य ऑल्सो इतराश्रम समभिव्याहारात् बिकॉज देर इज सह इतम आश्रम सम अलोंग बीइंग रेड अलोंग विद द अदर आश्रमस संन्यास आश्रम इज रेड विद द अदर आश्रमस एंड देर निदिध्यासन प्रधानम इज पारिव्राज्यम द फोर्थ आश्रम विच इज रेड अलोंग विद द अर्लियर थ्री देर not earlier three with other three this mauna read together with other three that is the meaning of samabhivyahara and therefore samabhivyaharat Itara ashrama samabhivyaharat. This parivrajyam is the meaning, and parivrajyam means what? It is nididhyasana pradhanam. Nididhyasanam pradhanam yasmin parivrajye tat parivrajyam nididhyasana pradhanam. Bhauri. Mauna shabdena lakshyate itya virodha iti avirodha. There is no virodha there. There is no dosha. There is no contradiction between my interpretation of mauna as nididhyasana and mauna there meaning sannyasa ashrama, because sannyasi is the primary adhikari for nididhyasana. In fact, he is the primary adhikari for shravana mana nididhyasana. Nanu kasya mauna vidhi rityataha. Who is this mauna vidhi for? If you say it is for the sannyasi or for others, or in sannyasa also, for whom? Really, who is the vidhi for? So, tatraha or ityataha. Therefore, Siddhanti answers when this doubt is there in the sutra, tadvataha. For tadvan is this vidhi. Viditva iti paroksha jnanavata sannyasina prakrutatva. Because sannyasi is intended there, for him is the vidhi. Therefore, mauna shabda, that means as sannyasa ashrama elsewhere in the smriti. Here it means nididhyasana, because nididhyasana is ordained for the paroksha jnanavan sannyasi, because it is following viditva, having known. So it is a vidwan who has paroksha jnana and then takes to sannyasa for nididhyasana, so that he can remain and convert that apparent paroksha jnana into aparoksha jnana. Prakrutatvat, because that is a context. Nanu sukshma vastu sakshatkare nididhyasana se svatah praptatvat vidhihi nirarthaka ityataha pakshena. So we saw in the sutra, while we looked at the sutra, pakshena means what? There's an objection there. Nanu sukshma vastu sakshatkare, for sakshatkar of the sukshma vastu, for any subtle thing we need nididhyasana. So nididhyasana svatah praptatvat, it is logically known that nididhyasana dhyana rupa or chintana rupa punah punah chintana rupa abhyasa, because nididhyasana is sananta ichharte san, and there is abhyasa karya also, duplication of the jhai dhatu. Ni purvaka jhai dhatu will become ni purvaka jhai dhyai. Then there will be abhyasa karya, haladi shesha ityadi, the yakara will go away, dhakara will remain, and then jastvam will be there. Dhakara will become third of the class, varga tritya, dakara, it will become dakara, and then aikara becomes ikara ityadi, and in the second case aikara becomes akara. So nididhyasana, thereby you get ni purvaka didhyasa, didhyasa or ni purvaka didhyasa dhatu. Didhyasa is the derived sananta dhatu, which means what? Ichharte san. Now ni purvaka didhyasa will give nididhyasa, and then lut will give nididhyasana. Nididhyasana se svatah praptatva, because of this abhyasa also repetition is known, and in subtle matter more focus is needed. So dhyana chintana is prapta automatically. Svabhavataha, in laukika it is well known. In loka it is well known. So it can be an anuvada. Why would there be a vidhi in the shruti? Therefore, vidhi is nirarthaka. It is meaningless for the shruti to give a vidhi, or for you to read mauna shabda as a vidhi. Atha munihi, there mauna as the munir bhavaha, that itself is not nididhyasana. It is wrong to read it as a vidhi, at least, says the Purvapakshi. Therefore, Siddhanti says pakshena, meaning yasmin pakshe, when there are multiple options. Here there are two options, meaning one already knows that nididhyasana has to be done because it is sukshma vastu sakshatkara, where subtle matter can be known only through nididhyasana. So yasmin pakshe bheda darshana prapti, but paroksha jnani does not have that because he has bheda darshana. So he is not focused on the subtle at all. He also has gross matter to deal with because the prapancha is dragging, the purva samskara is dragging this yati or a non-yati also, whereby he takes sannyasa to focus on nididhyasana for vidya. So yasmin pakshe bheda darshana prapti, even if he knows that there is a paroksha jnana, there is something called as Brahma, which is Jagat Karana, and Shruti says that I am that, so he knows all that, but then it remains paroksha because he thinks that Shruti says so, I don't think so, or it may be attained by others, but I am not there yet. Therefore, Bhedarshana Prapti is there for that paksha, in that paksha. Yasmin Pakshe Bhedarshana Prapti, Tena Pakshena Praptyatva. In whichever paksha it is prapta, Bhedarshana is prapta, there Nididhyasana is aprapta. There it is a vidhi, it is apurva there. So, Tena Pakshena, through that paksha, this Praptyabhavat, it is all not known that Sukshma Vastu needs Nidhyasana, therefore Vidhihi Arthavan Eva. Vidhi is Ki Pratyanta Pullinga Shabda. So Arthavan Eva Matupanta Arthavan. It has meaning. It is meaningful. Nanu Brahma Paravakye Katham Vidhihi Ityashankya Drishtantamaha. Purvapakshi says it is a Brahma Paravakya. All is section, there is an Ekavakyata finally. And you will say that in Jnanakanda this Ekavakyata is Mahavakya, where it is committed to revealing Brahma as the, as one's own nature. Jiva's very nature is Brahma, Satchidananda Brahma. So Brahma Paravakya, in a Vakya, which is committed to Brahma, revealing Brahma, Katham Vidhihi, how can there be a Vidhi? Ityashanga Drishtantamaha. To that, Siddhanti responds with an example. He says, Drishtantamaha Vidyadivata, like Vidhi elsewhere. In Karmakanda also you see videhe adhi vidyadi, that is samasa. So videhe adhi, it is a tatpurusha samasa. Videhe adhi vidyadi, meaning pradhana vidhi. At any vidhi if you see, what is at the beginning of the vidhi? Beginning meaning at the, there are series of vidhis. So all these vidhis, what is primary there? Adhi can be primary also, pradhanam. So pradhana vidhi. There is vidhi, do this, do this, do this, but then Agnihotra vidhi, for example, Agnihotra vidhi or Darsha Purnamasa vidhi ityadi. So Tadvat Pradhana vidhi, like the Pradhana vidhi, Tadvat meaning like the Pradhana vidhi, because Vidyadivat, Tadvat, Vidyadivat, Vidyadi is explained, so Tadvat is Vidyadivat, to land on the Sutra Shabda. So Tadvat means Vidyadivat, like the Pradhana vidhi. What is the meaning? Yatha Darsha Purnamasa Pradhana Pare Vakye. In the Vakya, which is committed to Pradhana Karma, which is a Pradhana Karma, Darsha Purnamasa. See, Darsha Purnamasa being done by the Grihastha, that is the main karma. So, in that Vakya, in the Vakya where Vakya is committed to the Pradhana, to the Darsha Purnamasa, the karma may or may not be Pradhana. What is Pradhana is Vakya. Pradhana Vidhi Vakya is there, where Darsha Purnamasa is Pradhanyena Vidhiyate, in that Vakya. So there are other Vidhis also, as to supporting, Angas are there. So Angi is Darsha Purnamasa there, being Pradhana, and in that Vakya following Vidhis are there. What is the following Vidhi? Anvadhana Dehe Angajatasi Vidhi. There is Anga Vidhi. Anuvadhana. So you have to kindle the fire well. So you add samit there and kindle the fire. Why would Shruti give such vidhi if Darsha Purnamasa Pradhana Vakya is, Paravakya is there, which has gone by? Still there Anga Vidhis are there. Does not mean that there cannot be following Vidhis also. So Shrotavya or Brahma Paravakya may have gone by in the Upanishad. But still there can be Anga Vidhis such as Nididhyasana. Nididhyasana is given as a Vidhi, Mauna. Nididhyasana is given as a Vidhi for one who has already got the Vidhi in the form of Shravana Vidhi, Brahma Paravakya. So Brahma Mahavakya, that Shravana has taken place. But then there is Nididhyasana Vidhi, which is Anga Vidhi. Similar to Anvadhana Dehe Angajatasya Vidhihi, Tadvat Maunasya Ityartha. Similarly is the case of Mauna. Nididhyasana is a Anga Vidhi compared to the Mahavakya, which has gone by, says the Purvapakshi. So Shravana is the Angi to which Mauna Ityadi, Nididhyasana, Manana are Angas. ननु एवं श्रवणादि प्रदाने कैवल्याश्रमे श्रुति सिद्धे कस्मात् छांदोग्ये अभिसमावृत्य कुटुंबे इति गृहिण उपसंहारः तत्राह। पूर्व पक्षी सेज सिद्धांति हैज गॉन अ लॉन्ग वे टू एस्टैब्लिश ज्ञान एज साधना फॉर मोक्ष, लेट मी ट्राई टू ब्रिंग इट बैक टू कर्म एज साधना। सो ही सेज लुक एट योर उपनिषद ऑल्सो, योर उपनिषद टॉक्स अबाउट श्रवणादि प्रधान एज मीन्स श्रवणाधि प्रधान इन दी संन्यास आश्रम। सो श्रवणाधि इज प्रधान फॉर हुम, फॉर अ सन्यासी। सो कैवल्य आश्रम इज संन्यास आश्रम, देर इज नथिंग एल्स टू डू, दिस इज द ओनली फोकस। वॉट इज द फोकस? श्रवणादि। सो श्रवणादि प्रधानम यस्मिन कैवल्याश्रमे, स कैवल्य आश्रम श्रवणादि प्रधान, इट विल बिकम पुल्लिंग बिकॉज आश्रम इज पुल्लिंग। सो संन्यास आश्रम कैवल्य आश्रम इज वन इन विच देर इज प्राधान्य ऑफ श्रवणादि। सो श्रवणादि इज प्रधान। सो ननु एवं इन दिस मैनर इन द संन्यास आश्रम कैवल्य आश्रम वेर यू हैव श्रवणादि प्राधान्य श्रुति सिद्धे हे आश्रमे श्रुति सिद्धे कस्मात् छांदोग्ये एंड इट इज श्रुति सिद्ध, यू आर एस्टैब्लिश्ड विद द बेसिस इन श्रुति। सो श्रुति सिद्धे कैवल्य आश्रमे, दैट संन्यास आश्रम विच इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड बाय श्रुति वेर श्रवणादि इज अ प्रधान विधि ऑल्सो टू दैट आश्रमी सन्यासी, देन इफ दैट इज द एंड गोल रियली इन योर ज्ञानकांड, कस्मात् छांदोग्ये, हाउ इन दैट केस, हाउ इज इट दैट इन छांदोग्य उपनिषद अभिसमावृत्य कुटुंबे इन द एट्थ विच इज द लास्ट चैप्टर इन 15th कांड फर्स्ट मंत्र इटसेल्फ सेज व्हाट, अभिसमावृत्य कुटुंबे। कुटुंबे मीनिंग गृहस्थ आश्रम इज बीइंग टॉक्ड अबाउट इन द एट चैप्टर। व्हाई वुड श्रुति टॉक अबाउट गृहस्थ आश्रम इति गृहिण गृहिण उपसंहारः, why is the upasamhara conclusion in grahasthashrama, why would the shruti do that? If the commitment is to sannyasa ashrama and jnana, then where jnana pradhanya is there, karma itself is not there, there is no samuchaya possible, then why is the shruti concluding with abhisamavritya kutumbe? Why is the shruti saying that having meaning grihana upasamhara, why is this shruti concluding into grahasthashrama where karma is pradhana, upasana is anga maybe, but karma is what the kaivalya ashrama sannyasi has given up, whereas the same jnanakanda which talks about kaivalya ashrama, it establishes the kaivalya ashrama, it is concluding in the grahasthashrama, how abhisamavritya levanta again. So it talks about the samavartana, thereby this upakurvana will become grahastha. So kutumbe, taking into the grahasthashrama, why would the shruti do that? Add that to jnana kanda antaragata shruti towards the end of the upanishad, that too at the 8th chapter, iti grihana upasamhara iti kasmat karanat, why is that? Kasmat heto, there is a grahastha ashrama being concluded in the upanishad tatraha, to that the siddhanti says krishna bhavat tu grihana upasamhara, krishna bhavat tu grihana upasamhara. So krishna bhavat tu गृहिण उपसंहार, सो गृहिण गृहिणस्य उपसंहार, वाई इज द कंक्लूजन शो, बिकॉज कृष्ण भावात, बिकॉज इन इट्स एंटायरिटी गृहस्थाश्रम कैन हैव ऑल साधनास। सो विल सी द मीनिंग इन द वृत्ति विच इज वेरी शॉर्ट, यज्ञादीनाम आश्रमांतर विहितानाम वा शमादीनाम गृहस्थाश्रमे कार्ष्ण्येन संभवात्। सो कृष्ण भाव इज वॉट? कार्ष्ण्यम, तस्य भाव कार्ष्ण्यम, सो कृष्णस्य भावः कार्ष्ण्यम्। सो कृष्ण भाव हैज बीन रिप्लेस्ड विद द भाव प्रत्यय, द वर्ड भाव इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय द भाव प्रत्यय एंड कार्ष्ण्येन, पंचमी इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू तृतीया विद संभवात्। सो सिंस दिस कार्ष्ण्य इन इट्स एंटायरिटी इट इज पॉसिबल बिकॉज इन गृहस्थाश्रम व्हाट ऑल इज देयर, कर्म इज देयर, what karma? Yajnyadi. Yajnyadi naam. And ashramantara vihitanam, which are there in other ashramas also, all of those are there. So ashramantara vihitanam va shamadhi naam. Shamadama is there for brahmachari also and for sannyasi also, and to a certain extent for the vanaprastha also. And it is prapta in grihastha ashrama as well. There is no reason why a grihastha is not able to follow shamadama ityadi. To a certain extent, maybe not completely, but to a certain extent he can also follow. So grihastha ashrama karsnena sambhavat. Yajna ityadi karma is also possible. Shamadamadi, which is for other ashramas, that is also possible in grihastha ashrama. Therefore, the Shruti concludes by talking about this particular ashrama, which is an ashrama which supports the other three also. That is also another perspective. Therefore, grihastha ashrama ena upasamhara. Shashti is common, so Tritiya is specific. So grihastha ashrama Tritiya tatpurusha grihastha ashrama ena upasamhara. There is a conclusion with the grihastha ashrama where all these values which are particular to other ashramas are common in grihastha ashrama, along with the ashrama karma which is particular only to the grihastha ashrama. Others do not have agnihotra ityadi. Natu sannyasa bhava ityartha, but not because sannyasa bhava is there. So Siddhanti is answering by reading the hidden agenda of the Purva Pakshi, where he says Kaivalya ashrama is Shruti Siddhe. So he says, if at all it had been Shruti Siddha, you are claiming Shruti Siddhattvam of Sannyasa Ashrama, but had it been so in Jnana Kanda, then why would it conclude in Grihastha Ashrama? Meaning this hidden agenda is that there is nothing called a Sannyasa Ashrama, therefore karma, Grihastha Ashrama karma itself will lead to mukti. This was the hidden agenda to which Siddhanti says natu sannyasa bhava. There is no reason to conclude that because grihastha ashrama, where sannyasa ashrama prapta shamadamadi are also possible, and that is why the grihastha ashrama is being discussed there, through which one has to go further and reach this sannyasa ashrama kramena. That is one possibility. Therefore it has been mentioned, but not because sannyasa ashrama is not there. Natu sannyasa ashrama bhava. Sannyasa bhava means natu sannyasa ashrama bhavat ityartha. Maunavad itaresham api upadeshat. This is in continuation. Maunavad itaresham api upadeshat. Maunavad itaresham api upadeshat. So the Siddhanti continues. Maunavad itaresham api upadeshat. Because of upadesha for others, maunavat. Because of the upadesha teaching. Api, because of the teaching for others also, itaresham api, maunavat, like mauna. So it is possible in grihastha ashrama also to follow mauna, nididhyasana. This is what the sutra means. The detail we see in the vritti, which is short, to not be repetitive. Maunasya garhastasya cha yatha shrutimatvam. How the Shruti ordains the Garhastya Dharma, similarly Sannyasa Ashrama Dharma also, Nididhyasana also, Maunasya cha yatha Shruti Mattvam. It is Shruti Siddha. Tadvat Brahmachari Vanaprasthayor api Shrutishu Upadeshat. So how this, it is Mauna is ordained for the Sannyasi, Nididhyasana, and Garhastasya. The grihastha dharma yajnyadi is ordained for the grihastha ashrama, shruti matvam. So similarly, tadvat brahmachari vanaprasthayorapi, for brahmachari and vanaprastha also, shrutishu upadesha. In shruti itself, there is an upadesha, what should they do? Tabhyam sa chatvara ashrama prasangaduktaha. So, in prasanga, this sutra is just mentioning that it is for others also. It is not that sannyasi, for sannyasi it was mentioned, and Purvapakshi said, objected as to why grihastha ashrama is mentioned there at all, if it is only for the sannyasi, or if there is something called a sannyasa ashrama where karma has to be given up. So he had a hidden agenda, but since it has been established that in grihastha ashrama also the sannyasi's mauna is also possible in grihastha ashrama, therefore it does not mean that there is no nididhyasana possible for a grihastha. But primarily, sannyasa ashrama is meant only for that, shravana mana nididhyasana. Therefore, for sannyasi it was explained, it does not mean that it is not possible for the grihastha. So therefore, grihastha has all of these possibilities including yajna. Therefore, that ashrama is also covered. Now, the other two are not covered at all. So, there may be confusion as to other two ashramas cannot have brahmachari, brahmachari ashrama and vanaprastha ashrama, antargata sadhakas cannot have this mauna ityadi. When that kind of a thinking may be there, suspected, it is suspected, and therefore sandharva prapta is this sutra where tabhyam saha chatvara ashrama prasangadukta. There is a prasanga sangati is also not mentioned because two have been mentioned, other two also should be mentioned. As to there also Shrutishu Upadeshat, all four ashramas are there, and there is also possibility of Shravana Mana Nididhyasana for them. That is also additional possibility of this sutra, meaning there are two meanings possible. Ashrama coverage is mentioned, or jnana in ashrama or jnana sadhana in all four ashramas can also be read here. Then why itaresha, meaning for the other two, why is plural being used? Shashti, bahuvachana, dual should have been used. If that is the objection, then Siddhanti says dvayoho bahuvachanam. Esham iti bahuvachanam, dvayoho, dvayoho kayoho, the brahmachari and brahmachari vanaprastha yoho. So brahmachari and vanaprastha are mentioned with a plural because of vritti bheda. So vritti bheda abhiprayakam. Vritti bhedaha abhiprayaha yasya. Yasya bahuvachanasya tad bahuvachanam vritti bheda abhiprayakam bahuri. So vritti bheda, because there are multiple vrittis here, although there are two ashramas, or vyakti bheda also is possible. Vritti bheda or vyakti bheda is also possible. It is explained in that manner also. So there are many who are brahmacharis and vanaprastha ashrama, vanaprasthis. Purva mauna shabdasya jnanatishaye nididhyasane prasiddhatvat nididhyasanam videyam ityuktam. So the adhikarana is over. Anavishkara adhikaranam comes up with a sangati as to purva pakshi gives another drishtant sangati. Purva mauna shabdasya jnanatishaye nididhyasane. When I say purva pakshi gives a drishtant sangati, purva pakshi brings up this as a drishtanta to another darshtantika, and thereby it becomes the drishtanta sangati for the siddhanti. So it's a shortcut way of saying that Purvapakshi gives a drishtanta sangati. Purvapakshi takes this as a drishtanta. That's what it means. So purvam mauna shabdasya jnanatishaye nididhyasane prasiddhatvat. In the jnanatishaya, when jnanatishaya takes place, then one gets absorbed in that tattva. It is but natural for the mind to behave in this manner. It is the nature of the mind. So whatever you feed it, it remains there. So samskara vashat. So when the jnana atishaya takes place, then one moves on to nididhyasana. Shravana phala is in mukti, in the jnana, jnanotpatti. And one remains in that jnana because it is one's own swarupa. One does not go away from one's swarupa. That is the jnana atishaya. So mauna shabda se jnana atishaye nididhyasane prasiddhatvat. So mauna shabda is in that meaning of nididhyasana. This prasiddha. Therefore, what nididhyasana vidhyam ityuktam, and therefore nididhyasana is the vidhi in the mauna shabda there. Said the siddhanti, tadvad balya shabdasya kamacharado prasiddehe tad vidhyam iti drishtanta sangatya idamaha. Now Purvapakshi says this, atha munihi atha brahmana. There you said the third is this muni shabda, atha munihi, this is the tritiya, and it means nididhyasana, this is Shravanadi apekshaya. So there is an apeksha left after Shravana as to the obstacle should be removed by Manana and Nididhyasana. So Nididhyasana is Prapta, and that is meant by the Muni Shabda. Now this Balyam cha Panditiyam cha Nirvidya Atha Muni, that is that statement, this Muni you said as Nididhyasana, but Balyam Shabda has gone by. If Muni is Prasiddha in the meaning of Nididhyasana where there is Jnanatishaya, then Balya also has a prasiddha meaning of childish or childlike. So why not take that meaning, prasiddha meaning, which is what kamacharadu prasiddhehe. सो काम बाल्य इन बाल्यावस्था अंडर द एज ऑफ 5 एटसेट्रा इन कल्चरली एंड इन धर्मशास्त्र ऑल्सो इट इज नोन देर इज वन कैन डू एनीथिंग दैट वन वॉन्ट्स एंड देर इज नो पापा इत्यादि नोबडी सीन्स इट आर रॉन्ग अप टू अ सर्टन एज ऑफ अ चाइल्ड एनीथिंग इज ओके इफ अदर्स डू इट इज फूलिश बट इफ अ चाइल्ड डज ओ आई मीन इट्स ओके आई मीन ही इज अ किड शी इज अ किड दिस इज वॉट वी से सो एनीथिंग लुक्स लाइक यू नो विभूति ऑफ परमेश्वर वी स्माइल विद द किड इवन इफ द किड इज डूइंग एनीथिंग एंड एवरीथिंग सो कामचारा दो यथेष्ट चेष्टा इज देर वॉट एवर दे लाइक दे डू इफ दे वॉन्ट टू ईट मट दे ईट मट इफ दे वॉन्ट टू थ्रो समथिंग दे थ्रो समथिंग सो यू नो इफ दे वॉन्ट टू जस्ट यू नो पास यूरिन ऑल्सो दैट्स वॉट इट विल बी सो फिल्थ एवरीवेयर इज ऑल्सो नॉर्मल इट इज वेल एक्सेप्टेड बाय एवरी वन इट इज प्रसिद्ध सो दिस इज कामचारादि इज दैट सो फॉर दि सन्यासी ऑल्सो हू दिस निधिध्यासन वन फॉर हूम दिस निधिध्यासन इज मेन्शन सो लेट देट बी बाल्य शब्द विच इज प्रसिद्ध इन द मीनिंग ऑफ कामचार काम आचार लेट इट बी यथेष्ट चेष्टा फॉर दि सन्यासी ऑल्सो तद विधेयम एंड सन्यासी कैन डू एनीथिंग एंड एवरीथिंग दैट इज वॉट दि विधि इज सेज दि पूर्वपक्षी इति दृष्टांत संगते दमः एंड देयर बाय अनाविष्कार अधिकरण हैज कम अप टू विच द सिद्धांत सेज अनाविष्कुर्वन्नन्वयात अनाविष्कुर्वन्नन्वयात सो दिस अनाविष्कुर्वन इज शत्रंत अन्वयात दिस डबल नकार इज ड्यू टू संधि सो देयर इज ओनली वन वन नकार देयर अनाविष्कुर्वन सो आविष्कार इज वॉट मैनिफेस्टेशन अनाविष्कार इज नॉन मैनिफेस्टेशन सो वर्तमान काले शत्रु इज देयर सो लट शत्रुशानचो सो शत्रु इज ऑर्डेन इन द प्लेस ऑफ लट विच इज वर्तमान लट सो इट इज इन द मीनिंग ऑफ वर्तमान काल सो अनाविष्कुर्वन मीन्स नॉन मैनिफेस्टिंग वाइल नॉट मैनिफेस्टिंग वाई अन्वयात नॉट मैनिफेस्टिंग वन्स ओन गुणा सन्यासी शुड रिमेन एज अ बाल सो वन मीनिंग वॉज सीन एज बाल्यम मीन्स बाल्य शब्द दि स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ दि ज्ञान बट दि अदर मीनिंग इज दैट दिस बाल्य इज वॉट विदाउट शोकेसिंग वन्स ओन गुणास सन्यासी गुणास वन्स बेसिकली वॉट कीपिंग अ लो प्रोफाइल जड़वल लोकम आचरेत इज सेड एल्सवेयर इन कारिका वी सी दैट आफ्टर ज्ञान प्राप्ति जड़वत लोकम आचरेत Remain like a jada, remain like any other person and even lower than a common man kind of a profile. You remain to yourself because otherwise one cannot do nididhyasana. And thereby atha munihi, that is also one way. So don't go and, you know, in Hindi say dhindora pitne ka koi jarurat nahi hai. What is the point in saying that, oh, I'm a jnani and just you go around and yell out. So you remain to yourself. If there is a need, then you interact with the society. Otherwise, there is no need as such. This is the meaning there. Why? Hetu is anvayat. Because such anvaya is there, which will be seen in the vritti. Atra purvapakshe kamacharadehe vidyangatvena anushthanam. So, balya means kamachara. One can do whatever one likes. And there are many people who think in this manner also. They say that the highest sannyasa is what? Is Paramahamsa sannyasa. Out of the four types of sannyasa, Paramahamsa is the highest sannyasa where there is no danda, nobody needs to object to whatever he does, he can do whatever he wants. This is the literal interpretation of Paramahamsa. Paramahamsa can do anything that he wants, but that anything he wants means that he does not do anything. That is the meaning. That kind of level of jnana should be there. Jnana nishtha should be, brahmanishtattvam should be at that level where no vidhi is applicable, no nisheda is applicable. One has gone beyond the sannyasa rituals also where one is not considering, oh, I have to take bath 3 times a day because I am a sannyasi. He does not even have to think about that. It is automatic that he may or may not take a bath. But it cannot be with choice. Oh, I don't want to take a bath. Why should I do this? Why should I follow danda niyama ityadi? Why should I follow sannyasa dharma? Why should I have limited bhojana as mentioned in the yati dharma niranaya ityadi? Why I can eat whatever I want, whenever I want? At night, midnight also, if I feel like eating, I can eat because it is Sharira Dharma and I don't care because there is no rule applicable to me. That is not the meaning there. It is only by jnana that one has gone beyond dharma because Sharira Bhava itself is lost. One cannot be choosy in eating, etc. There is no, there is no Ardhajarati and Nyaya there. Therefore, what? This Kamachara Dehe seen by Purvapakshi is not right. He says Vidya Angatvena Anushthanam. So, one should remain like a Bala means one can do whatever one wants like a Bala, meaning that is childish really, not childlike. It is childish. So vidyangatvena anushthanam. Siddhante bhavashuddhe eva iti phalaveda. Bhavashuddhe. In siddhanti, bhava is in the meaning of antakkarana. Antakkarana shuddhehe eva iti phalaveda. Meaning balya, in the bala avastha, there is innocence. Antakkarana shuddhi need not be done there. Because the samskaras which are there in the antakkarana, they do not start manifesting until a certain age. So Bhagavan lets the child enjoy, or you can say Bhagavan enjoys as a child. That's why in the Krishna avatar also, Bala Krishna has quite a different value or different kind of devotion than the Krishna of the Mahabharata Gita Acharya. So there is also, because Krishna Leela and all is seen as a different matter. But when Krishna as a Bala, there is a different vibhuti. So, there is some specific reason why Balya is really enjoyable for everyone, be it somebody else's. So, there, Bhava Shuddhi, Antakrana Shuddhi is the meaning. They have innocence, and innocence is their very nature. As such, Bhava Shuddhi Heva, the Paramahamsa Sannyasi also here, this Sannyasi should have that kind of innocence in that sense, meaning he should remain without bheda at all. Bala also does not have any bheda. If the balaka is asked, you know, who are your parents, who are you, what sambandha do you have, and all such details, he doesn't know, he does not talk about it also. He cannot talk about it. Similar should be the state of this sannyasi, who has no purvashrama, who has nothing at all. There is no discussion needed there. He is like a child who has no past or future really. That kind of a state is Bhavashuddhi here. Bhavashuddhi evaiti phalaveda. Purva udahruta shrutav balya shabdine kim balyasya karma kamacharadikam vidhiyate uta bhavashuddhi riti samshe kamacharadikam iti purva paksha siddhantastu avyakta lingo avyaktacharaha iti shrute. There is a javala shruti for this interpretation. The sangraha vakya itself is being elaborated here as to the Purva Udharana Shruti, the Shruti which was given as an exemplified, Udahruta, as an exemplified with Balya, Balyam cha, Panditya'm cha, Nirvidya, Athamunihi. So there Balya Shabda, what does it stand for? Does it stand for Balyasya Karma? Because there is a Shyanj Pratyaya, Balyasya Karma or Balasya, not Balyasya, Balasya Karma, Balyam. So that is the meaning, is that the meaning, which is what? Kamacharadikam. Do whatever you like a kid does. Vidhiyate, and it is a vidhi. Is it so, or bhava shuddhi, or is it just innocence and the clean mind as a child? Iti samshe, when such doubt comes up, kamachara adhikam iti purvapaksha. The sannyasi should do anything, not could or would, should do anything that is a vidhi, say, or could also. You can say should, would, and could, all three meanings apply to vidhiling. So vidhiyate iti purvapaksha. Purvapakshi says so, whereas Siddhanti says Siddhantastu avyakta linga. He should not manifest his lingas, meaning he should not keep projecting his gunas to others, showcasing his gunas to others, avyakta achara. And his achara also, whatever is achara, it should be avyakta. It should not be, oh, I do this, I do that, all that. None of that should be there. It all should be unmanifest, meaning it should not be made visible to others. So he follows his dharma and he does what needs to be done, but he does not need to showcase it to others, and he remains like a child in his own swarupa. That is a jabala shruti iti shrute swaguna prakhyapana adi bhihi anavishkurvan atmanam aprakhyapayan bhava shuddha bhaved iti etavan matram vidhyate. So what is the vidhi there? remain like a bala, have balya, and what is that? Swaguna, one's own guna, prakhyapanadi bhihi anavishkurvan. Without manifesting what? One's own gunas, talking about it and publicizing it, not doing that, anavishkurvan. Atmano aprakhyapan payan. So not making oneself famous. Thereby bhava shuddha bhavet, remain free from all such entanglements. That is the idea there. Remain like an innocent child. Iti etavan matram vidyate. It is a vidhi all right, but balya vidhi is there. Remain like a child with childlike innocence and not chattering like others who have some agenda. The child has no agenda. Child just wants to be happy, and he is happy with this or that. If this, then some particular toy is taken away, he is happy with another also. So general case, I am talking about general case with a general example. Tavan matrasya pradhane jnanabhyase anvayat, because there is anuvritti of that in the jnanabhyasa. If one gives up jnanabhyasa and keeps on doing all sorts of things, projecting oneself as a great acharya or who has had a great past, that I was an engineer doctor earlier, this entire crowd that you get will be that. It will not be a crowd which is, crowd itself is not good for a sannyasi, but jnanabhyase anvaya is of this only this innocent being. Like a bala, childlike sannyasi alone will have anvaya in this, that kind of balya alone will have anvaya in jnanabhyasa. It will go together. Anvaya here in sense, it will go together with jnanabhyasa. Other things won't. You try to become famous, that will not go well with jnanabhyasa. I'm just giving a very toned down kind of a meaning, because all sorts of meanings are applicable, which we have seen. Na kamacharadikam, but the meaning of kamachara is not what is meant by balya, although balya includes that. That is not the vidhi there. Tasya tatra ananvayat, because it will not go well with kamachara. So hetu is given, because balya kamachara means what? He'll do ashaucha anywhere. So shauchadi dharma vidhai shastra virodachaiti, because shauchaityadi snana thrice a day is mentioned for the sannyasi. Somehow you fight to get the child have one bath also. So shauchadi dharma vidhai shastra, that shastra virodha will be there if this person also sannyasi who should take bath thrice starts to fight taking a bath even once using his antakarana and buddhi. He says, no, no, the balya vidhi is there, I can do whatever I like, so why should I have a bath? Children don't have a bath, parents have to bathe them, and still the child says, I won't have a bath, so let me also do the same. That is not the case at all, because there is virodha with such shastra. Even sannyasi has a shastra to follow. It is not that sannyasi is without shastra. Two more sutras left. Let me continue and finish this. Purvam mauna shabdasya jnanati chet. Oh, this is done. So sorry. Aikadikaranam is the next adhikaranam, which is introduced by saying, Itham sannyasadi balyantam sadhana jatam abhidaya tat sadhya vidya janma vicharyate iti hetu hetumad bhava sangatya namaha. After a long time, we have got a hetu hetumad bhava sangati. Earlier adhikarana is hetu to this one. What is the earlier adhikarana? Itham sannyasadi balyantam. Starting not earlier adhikarana one only, multiple. So sannyasadi balyantam, starting with sannyasa nischaya there and balyantam, ending with balya as the sannyasi dharma which is discussed there, vidhi. So sadhana jatam abhidaya, these are all sadhanas to the sannyasi. Sannyasi has sannyasa ashrama sadhana also to follow, and balyantam such vidhis are also there. So having discussed abhidaya, tat sadhya vidya janma vicharyate. So vidya janma is vidya utpatti. What is, if the sannyasadi and balya, ending with balya, beginning with sannyasa, ending with balya, and everything that is discussed in between in the with the adi pada, these are all sadhana. Sadhana jatam is what? Sadhana, group of sadhana. Jata is samuha. So sadhana samuha has been talked about. Having talked about that, what is the sadhya? Sadhya, tat sadhya is this sannyasadi balyanta sadhana jata sadhyam. What is sadhya? What is the goal? What is attained with this sadhana? Vidya Utpatti. Brahma Vidya Utpatti will take place when you follow this sadhana. Thereby, this Vidya Janma is possible only with the Hetu of sadhanas being there, because phala is sadhya. Therefore, Hetu Hetu Mad Bhava Sangati is there. Vicharyate iti Hetu Hetu Mad Bhava Sangati Aitamaha. Sadhana Hetu being there, sadhya Brahma Vidya Janma Utpatti Hetu Mat is being inquired into. Therefore, there is a Hetu Hetu Mat Bhava Sangati. One is a cause, the other is the effect. So, the effect Ahika Adhikarana has come up. So, where does this Vidya take place? That is the question. So, now there are two questions pending. I'll just mention in 51st Sutra the question regarding Jnana. Where and how, when, all this kind of a question can be there. Where does this Brahma Vidya, which is Sadhya, to the sadhanas discuss? When and where does it come up? Or when does it come up? Where does it come up? That kind of a question is there. Then, what is the phala of this Vidya? Moksha. So, 52nd Sutra context will be, what about this Moksha? Moksha also, wherever Vidya comes up, there whatever rule is seen in regarding Vidya, where Vidya can come up, similar can be the case with Moksha also. So, that kind of Sangati will be there, whereby the 52nd Sutra will deal with moksha as the vishaya, whereas 51st sutra, current sutra, is going to be with the vishaya of vidya, Brahma Vidya. So Brahma Vidya and moksha as sadhya are remaining to be discussed. These are taken up in the next two sutra. So Ahika Adhikarana, thereby Hetu Hetu Mat Bhava Sangati gives this sutra. 51st sutra says Ahikam Apya Prastuta Pratibandhe Tad Darshanat. Aihikam apya prastuta prati bandhe taddarshanat. So taddarshanat, taddarshanat means this kind of a thing is seen in Shruti. What is seen? Aihikam. Aihikam is iha. Iha bhava aihikam. What is here? Taddhita. With iha. Here itself. Not here itself. Aihikam api. Here also. So, Jnanotpatti Vidya, where is the Vidya Utpatti? Vidya Utpatti can be here also, it can be in another loka also, Brahma Loka. So, Krama Mukti is possible, Jivan Mukti is possible. Jivan Mukti is by Brahma Jnana Utpatti here and now. And if the Jnana does not take place here, it can take place in, because Prarabdha may get over before the Jnana Utpatti. So, Sharira will come to an end, but due to the Sadhana, Upasana or Jnana also, one may get Brahma Loka, and the Jnanotpatti can be in that Loka also. It can be in this Loka again. One may take Janma again here itself, and one may get Moksha here with or without Sadhana in that Janma, because this very Sadhana will trigger the Jnana, can trigger the Jnana when the Pratibandhaka goes away. If Shravana has been done and there is Nischaya, then what happens is that if there is for Jnanotpatti itself, Aparoksha Jnanotpatti, if there is some obstacle, then there can be another Janma like Vamadeva. Vamadeva in the Garbha itself, he attained Jnana because of the Shravana in the earlier Janma, but Manan Vidyasana not being sufficient, there was some obstacle, very little left, which went away by Garbhavasa itself. So, possibility is there. So, Purva Pakshi, we will see what is the meaning here, because there is no introduction. Hetu Hetu Bhava Sangati is given, but what is the Purva Paksha that has not been mentioned? We will see in the Vritti. But Sutra Artha is Aihikam Api Aprastuta Pratibandhe Tad Darshanat. So, what has been said? Aprastuta Pratibandhe. When the Pratibandha is Prastuta, then Jnana, when it is there. Currently, if there is Pratibandha to Jnana, then Jnanotpi Patti won't take place. It is like saying that fire is there as source, I want to light wood, but what happens is that this Indhana is not burning. Wood is not burning. Why? Because it is wet. So, wetness in the wood is Pratibandhaka. So, Prastuta Pratibandhe, the wet wood won't catch fire. But over a period of time, you just leave it there. The same fire or the heat around can dry the wood. And after the wood is dried, then Aprastuta Pratibandhe Sati, what will happen? The wood will burn with the same fire. Shravana fire itself can give rise to the Jnana, and Jnana Agnihi Bhasmasat Kurute Karsnena. It will complete, because Bhasmasat is there. Sating is in Karsne Artha. Completely burn away all karma. avidya with its karya. So where it will take place? Siddhanti says to the Purvapakshi, says that meaning there are multiple Purvapakshas can be read. He says that here itself. Siddhanti says here also. Or he says no, jnana won't come up by, because there is no karma. So all this can be seen as Purvapaksha. We'll see what Purvapaksha is considered in the vritti. So, Siddhanti is saying api, because meaning here also it is possible. If the Purvapakshi says no, it is not possible here, in another loka only, Siddhanti says here also it is possible. If Purvapakshi says here only it is possible, not in another loka, then Siddhanti says here also it is possible. So all sorts of Purvapakshas can be seen, and therefore ahikam api aprastuta pratibande. The condition is that there should be no pratibandha, obstacle to jnanotpatti, then jnanotpatti will take place, brahma jnana will take place tad darshanat, because it has been seen in shruti, where we will see in the vritti. Atra purvapakshe shravanadehe vidya sadhanatva asiddhihi. Vidya is not, shravanadi is not sadhana for vidya, says the purvapakshi. Siddhante pratibandhaka vashad vilambe api tat siddhirti phalabheda. So Siddhanti says that pratibandhaka vashad, being obstacles being there, being blocked by obstacles, vidya may have vilamba, vilambe api. Even if vidya is delayed, vidya utpatti is delayed, still tatsiddhir, meaning the same shravana manidhyasana is sadhana for brahma vidya. It may not be apparent in case where in balavastha or in garbhavastha itself somebody has got jnana in shruti or in loka we see. Iti phalabheda. Tatra shravanadivihi kim ihaiva vidyotpatti uta kadachid amutra api iti samshe. Can the vidya utpatti take place here or in another loka? Also, when that doubt comes up, ihaiva vidya janmastu iti kamanaya shravanadishu pravrutte ahikam eva vidya janma iti purvapaksha. Purvapakshi says that here itself it should take place. That's why we saw both sangatis. Both kind of minds are there. If he is saying Shravanadi is not Vidya Sadhana, then how can he say that here itself let there be Vidya Utpatti in this life itself? He is saying both put together, he may be saying that with karma itself it will take place. So multiple possibilities are there. Purvapakshi says that Vidya Janma Iha Evastu, here itself, only in this loka, not in any other loka, because there is a kamana like that. Shravanadishu Pravrutti, why did he indulge in Shravanadi? So this is a different Purvapakshana. Shravanadehe vidya sadhanatva asiddhi. If it is not vidya sadhana, then why would he say that here itself let there be vidya janma due to shravana? Therefore I said there are multiple sangatis possible. Both are mentioned here. Ahikame vidya janma iti Purvapaksha. Purvapaksha says that here itself vidya janma is there. It will not be in another loka or another janma. Siddhantastu phalonmukham vidya viruddha phalakam karma prastuta pratibandha. What is prastuta pratibandha? Pratibandha which has presented itself, which is that some karma which is pending, which is what? Vidya viruddha phalakam. It is giving phala opposite to vidya. For example, you imagine this. Somebody wants to take sannyasa, but there is some slight desire for wealth, and suddenly he comes into a lot of wealth. Just some odd example. So bhoga is there and he had desire, so that will take precedence. He'll say that let me enjoy, I have not been able to enjoy this in this life. Suddenly those desires come at the forefront, and then the person thinks that I have so much of money, I didn't have, why would I take sannyasa now? So I'm giving some kind of an odd example there. So phalonmukham vidya viruddha phalakam, so which is viruddha to vidya, to enjoy the worldly objects is not the goal of this mumukshu. But what has happened is that there is so much of pratibandha that he was preparing to leave, but then all of these will present themselves in the form of grahas also. So the graha dasha will be such that gochara phala will be that this fellow will be pushed into bhoga. So phalonmukham vidya viruddha phalakam, they will give some one who is focusing and actually has moved away from this, but he will be made to face these phalas instead of the phala that he wants, he thought he wanted, in the form of moksha. So tasmin pratibandhakabha, when that pratibandhaka also goes away, I am giving a good example, there can be bad examples also as to he is tied due to whatever reasons. So those are well known. I am talking about even some good things can bind. So tasmin pratibandhaka bhave sati aihikam vidya janma shravanadi bhi bhavatyeva. So shravanadi, with shravanadi, this vidya janma will definitely take place if there is no pratibandha. Pratibandhaka abhava is there. In this very janma, if these pratibandhakas, whether they are giving punya phala sukha or papa phala dukkha, when they also go away, then aihika, in this very janma, there will be vidya utpatti, vidya janma. Due to what? Same shravanadi that one is doing or has done. Satitu pratibande amutra api iti aniyamaha eva. And there is no rule that it should take place here itself. Jivan mukti is not the only moksha. Jnanena moksha, that jnana can take place here also, or like Indra, Virochana, Ityadi in Brahmaloka also. So amutra api, it is possible. Krama mukti is possible. So one goes to the Brahmaloka, there one gets jnana, and at the end of the at the end of the kalpa, when Brahma also resolves, Chaturmukha Brahma, that time the vidya will give phala in the sense of videha mukti there. Natu iha eva iti niyama. It is not, there is no hard and fast rule that jivan mukti alone and in this very janma it will take place. Kutaha tad darshanat. It may be here after dropping this body and taking another body. That is also possible. Kutaha tad darshanat. It is seen in the Shruti. Garbha eva itachayano vamadeva eva muvacha iti shravanayapi bahubhiryo nalabhya ityadi shrutishu pratibandha pratibandha bhyam tasya niyamasya darshanad ityartha. This niyama, that here itself it should take place or elsewhere also it can take place, such niyama is not there. What kind of niyama is seen? It can take place here also, it can take place elsewhere also. It can take place in this janma also, it can take place in another janma also. Where do you see that? Garbhe eva. In the garbha itself, etachayana, this Vamadeva who is sleeping in the garbha, in the mother's womb, and there itself, Vamadeva evumacha, he, Manurabhuvam or all that jnana that he got is without shravana in this janma, but earlier shravana gave phala because pratibandha was in the form of this very garbhavasa. That's all this was pending, that was pending. So there itself shravana gave phala, so it was a different janma iti. And shravana api bahubhir yaha na labhyaha, even for shravana this tattva is not available. Ityadi shrutishu pratibandha apratibandha abhyam. So pratibandha goes away, jnana utpatti in garbha itself, and in the entire life one does not even get to hear about this Brahma Tattva, Paramatma Tattva or Paramatma, Atma, Ityadi Shrutishu. So, I think this is Kata Shruti. So, thereby Ityadi Shrutishu, Pratibandha, Apratibandha. Pratibandha is there in Shravanayapi, Bahubhiryona Labhya, Shruti, that is Pramana there. And Apratibandha in the case of Vamadeva, Evam Vacha. Thereby what? Tasya Niyamasya Darshanad Ityartha. This kind of a Niyama as to what? Aniyama. Aniyama is the Niyama, meaning it can be here also, elsewhere also, in another janma also. It can be Jivan Mukti also, it can be Krama Mukti also. There is no hard and fast rule. But such niyama is seen in both ways. It is seen in the Shruti. Purvam yatha vidyayaha ahika amushmikatva vishesha niyama ukta tatha tatphalepi mokshe kaschid utkarshadi vishesha niyama syaditi drishtant sangatya idamaha. So, Purvapakshi says, with a drishtanta sangati, just like you establish that vidya can give phala here or elsewhere, that kind of a vishesha niyama was mentioned. It can be here also, some vishesha have shown, it can be elsewhere also. So vishesha niyama was shown, meaning it will be particular to, it is subjective. Not everyone will get the same phala here itself, some or all will get in another loka, Brahma loka, or all will get in another janma. There is no such rule. So some vishesha niyama, particularly applicable to people based on their prarabdha, their sadhana. Tatha tatphale api mokshe. Then the vidya, tatphala is vidya phala. Brahma vidya phala is moksha. With respect to vishesha saptami, tatphale vidya phale mokshe api vishaye api kaschid utkarshadi vishesha niyama syad. There, let there be some utkarsha, subjectivity there also, as to one will get here, another will get moksha elsewhere after jnana utpatti. So moksha, can the moksha be here or elsewhere after jnana taking place here? Iti drishtanta sangatya idamaha. It can, says the Purvapakshi. Thereby the last adhikarana in this pada and this adhyaya is mukti phala aniyamadhikarana. Mukti phala aniyamadhikarana. And the last sutra there is eva mukti phala aniyamas tadavasthavadhrutehe. Eva mukti phala aniyamas tadavasthavadhrutehe. So evam mukti phala aniyamaha. Mukti phala aniyamaha. Tadavastavadhrutehe. The last word is mentioned twice because of the adhyaya samapti. So, evam, in this manner, mukti phala aniyama. There is no such niyama, meaning particularity with respect to mukti phala. Mukti is a phala of vidya which is attained as soon as jnana takes place. As soon as jnanotpatti, aparoksha jnanotpatti, brahma vidya utpatti takes place, then itself moksha is attained. Jivan mukti. Then prarabdha is there, therefore body continues and it will drop off and one will get videha mukti, but moksha is guaranteed then itself. Tad avastha avadhrutehe. Because tad avastha avadhruti is there. Panchami hetu there. Because such a mukti avastha, tad avastha is mukti avastha avadhrutehe. It has been mentioned so in the Shruti. It has been ascertained. It has been ascertained. Avadhruti is avadharana. Avadhruti is tin pratya. Avadharana is lut pratya. So there is an avadharana. There is indeed such a result will accrue. This kind of an ascertainment is there in the Shastra. Therefore what? Mukti phala aniyama. There is no particular segmentation in mukti phala. It will be available to all who have brahma jnana then and there itself. Wherever they get this jnana. Atra Purvapakshi karma sadhya mukti. In the last sutra also, Purvapakshi says that no, this vidya will not give mukti, moksha. Vidya may be there through Upanishad, but mukti will not be there. It will be possible only through karma. Siddhante jnana eka abhivyakta mukti iti phalabheda. Jnana eka abhivyakta. Jnanena ekena. Ekena. Not by any other means. Jnanena ekena eva. Mukti is not sadhya by the way, it is abhivyakta. Mukti is the very nature of Atma, that is our own swarupa. So moksha and mukti is not something that is prapta, so it is not sadhya. We say jnana sadhya mukti, it is figurative, but it is not really sadhya, some goal to be attained. It is to take away everything which is an obstacle to remain in one's own swarupa. Therefore, it is manifestation of one's own unmanifest mukti avastha swarupa, which seems unmanifest. So jnane eka abhivyakta mukti hi iti phalabheda. Mukti ratra vishaya. So vishaya is mukti itself, moksha. Tasyaha kim vidyavat vishesha niyama asti navayati sandehe asti iti purvapaksha. Is there niyama regard to moksha utpatti also, just like vidya utpatti in the earlier adhikarana? Purvapakshi says yes, definitely there should be niyama, similar niyama. Evam siddhantastu. However, Siddhanta is evam in this manner, vidyavat, like vidya, mukti rupa phalasya aniyama. Meaning, like vidya, this is a vaidharmya udharana. The udharana is vaidharmya, drishtanta is vaidharmya. Meaning, unlike evam, just like vidya, it is not so. So, aniyama, therefore, vidyavat aniyama means unlike vidya. Unlike vidya, where there is niyama as to it will come up in this janma or it will come up in another janma based on one's own background. Such is not the case with mukti. If vidya has come up, vidya utpatti has taken place, then mukti will be there for everyone. Whoever has got vidya will get mukti also. It is not that vidya has come up here, but based on the background, the person will get mukti elsewhere. It is not so. Mukti rupa phalasya aniyamaha. So it is a vaidharmya drishtanta. Nirvisheshattvam eva. There is no vishesha, there is no difference in one jnani and the other jnani is mukti. Every jnani has gained mukti here and now. कुतः वायसो तदवस्था अवधृते तदवस्था इज मुक्ति अवस्था सो तदवस्थाया अवधृते षष्ठी समास तत्पुरुष मुक्ति अवस्थायाः अवधृते मुक्ति अवस्था मीन्स व्हाट निर्विशेष ब्रह्म रूपत्वेन ब्रह्म वेद ब्रह्मैव भवति इति सर्वश्रुतिषु अवधारणात् मुक्ति अवस्था इज इट ब्रह्म भाव एंड निर्विशेष ब्रह्म रूपत्वेन इज द मीनिंग ऑफ मुक्ति अवस्था सो वन रिमेन्स एज निर्गुण ब्रह्म इन दैट वेरी नेचर वन रिमेन्स एंड वॉट इज द अवधारणा ब्रह्म वेद ब्रह्मैव भवति इति सर्वश्रुतिषु अवधारणात् अवधारणात् इज द मीनिंग गिवन विथ अ डिफरेंट प्रत्यय टू अवधृति विच इज अ तिनंत प्रत्यय तिनंत शब्द सो सर्वश्रुतिषु अवधारणा बिकॉज ऑफ एसरटेनमेंट इन ऑल श्रुति इज लाइक दैट ब्रह्म वेद वन हू नोज ब्रह्म रिमेन्स ब्रह्म ब्रह्म एव भवति रिमेन्स ओनली एज ब्रह्म नॉट एज अब्रह्म ही हैज नो संबंध विद दि अहंकारादि स्थूल शरीरांत प्रपंचांत और बंध ही हैज नो एसोसिएशन विद बंध एट ऑल देर इज नो तादात्म्य संबंध तस्माद् विद्या समकाला एव मुक्ति ही सो मुक्ति इज वॉट विद्या समकाला एव इट इज एट दिस टाइम ऑफ द विद्या उत्पत्ति इटसेल्फ मुक्ति टेक्स प्लेस सा च निरतिशय आनंद ब्रह्म स्वरूप एव इति सिद्धम एंड व्हाट इज द नेचर ऑफ दैट मुक्ति व्हाट इज द लक्षण कैरेक्टरिस्टिक निरतिशय आनंद ब्रह्म स्वरूप एव सो ब्रह्म स्वरूप स्वरूप सच्चिदानंद सो आनंद स्वरूप इज देर एंड इज देर एनी थिंग बेटर देन दैट आनंद नो ऑल विषय आनंद इज अभिव्यक्ति ऑफ दिस वेरी आनंद ब्रह्मानंद देर फोर निरतिशय आनंद ब्रह्म स्वरूप एव इति सिद्धम दिस इज एस्टाब्लिश्ड इन टोटालिटी इन टोटो सो पदाभ्यास वॉट अवर्स अवध तरवस्थावधृते तरवस्थावधृते दि पदाभ्यास दि वर्ड बीइंग रिपीटेड इज फॉर वॉट पर्पस पदाभ्यास अध्याय परिसमाप्ति द्योतनार्थ इट इज टू रिवील रिवील दैट दि अध्याय वेन यू चैंट देन वी वोंट नो दैट देर इज अध्याय समाप्ति अनलेस देर इज रिपीटेशन ऑफ दि वर्ड विच मार्क्स दि एंड ऑफ दि पाठ ऑफ द अध्याय अध्याय पाठ देन देर इज अ मंगलाचरण बाय दि वृत्तिकार नॉट वृत्तिकार वृत्तिकार वर्ड इज यूज फॉर समवन सो भगवान सदाशिव ब्रह्मेन्द्र मेक्स अ मंगलाचरण एट दि एंड ऑफ दि अध्याय यदैक्यमत्ये वैराग्य तत्त्वमर्थोपसंहृतिः शांति आदि साधनम सर्वं प्रत्यपादीतरस्म्यहम् सो यद ऐक्यमत्ये फॉर यस्य ऐक्यमति यस्य ब्रह्मणः ब्रह्मात्मनः ऐक्यमत्ये ऐक्यमति फॉर दि ऐक्यमति विथ दैट ब्रह्म ऑफ दैट ब्रह्म और ब्रह्मात्मा ऐक्य भाव बिटवीन ब्रह्म एंड आत्मा देर इज ऐक्य सो फॉर दैट काइंड ऑफ अ मति तादर्थ्य चतुर्थी फॉर दैट यद ऐक्यमत्ये चतुर्थी एक वचन वैराग्य तत् एंड त्वम अर्थ पदार्थ शोधना वॉज डन उपसंवृति ही तत् एंड त्वम पदार्थ तत्पदार्थ एंड त्वम पदार्थ शोधना वॉज डन उपसंवृति वॉज डन एंड नॉट ओनली वैराग्य तत्त्वम पदार्थ शोधना बट शांत्यादि शमदमादि साधना वॉज मेन्शन वॉज ऑर्डेन्ड सर्वम ऑल ऑफ दैट For which purpose was all of this vairagya, tattvam, artha, pada, tattva, pata, tatpada, tvam, pada, artha, padartha, shodhana was done. And shamadamadi was ordained as sadhana. Sarvam pratyapadi, all this was ordained. Tad asmi aham, that very Brahma I am. That ekam eva advitya brahma for which purpose vairagya shamadamadi sadhana tattvam padartha shodhana all of it if what is missing all that sharvanamana nidhyasana can be adi padena it can be included and sarvam everything that was ordained by the shruti at any place it was only for this purpose in karma kanda upasana kanda also whatever was ordained it is only for this brahma aikya mati and there that brahma tad अहमस्मी यद एंड तद आर इन सामानादिक तद अहमस्मी सेज भगवान सदाशिव ब्रह्मेन्द्र इति श्रीमत परिमहर इति श्रीमत परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्य श्री परम शिवेन्द्र सरस्वती पादाब्ज सेवा परायणेन श्री सदाशिवेन्द्र सरस्वत्या विरचितायाम श्रीमद ब्रह्म सूत्र वृत्तौ ब्रह्मतत्व प्रकाशिकायां तृतीय अध्याय वी हैव सीन दिस मीनिंग सो आई विल स्किप दिस आमना यन्ते संसिद्धम आदि मध्यांत वर्जितम आनंद घनम अपूर्णम आत्म ज्योतिर उपासमहे थैंक्स फॉर द सेकंड पार्ट हा टुडे इटसेल्फ एंड अ लॉन्गर वन वन एंड हाफ आवर्स बट वी विल
थैंक्स फॉर योर टाइम प्रवीण जी श्योर
सो आई विल सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट हा व्हेन वी डू इट इन द
श्योर थैंक यू
नमस्ते धन्यवाद
हां नमस्ते